Hello everyone, today I will salvage some electronic parts from older telephones. This video won't be too much interesting because I will do just salvaging the parts, not any tinkering or reverse engineering. So please don't be shy and let me know if you like this kind of teardown segments, because there's a lot of teardown videos on the internet, or if you like more hacking or playing with electronics videos. I will listen to that. So let's take off the cover and what we can see. This is the typical rubber keyboard. Nothing fancy. The PCB is a typical cheapish PCB. It is a single side PCB with all the through hole parts only. And it's made from that paper kind of material. I like the switches, but I have a lot of them, so I will not salvage them. The speaker looks interesting. And these switches, they are always custom on these phones, so I will take a look how this switch is working inside. There are various springs. So let's keep the speaker, ringtone speaker. So inside the switch there's small spring and lever, and this switch is a typical double pole, double throw. Nothing more interesting, so the PCB goes to the bin, and now let's take a look on the headphone itself. One screw. I would never thought that I would find a weight in a headphone, but this makes sense. This weight helps to press the switch, the contact switch, when you hang up the phone. And again, headphone goes to the trash. And that's all from the first telephone. Let's move to the second phone. This is not the Czech type phone. This is seems like it's from Italy. Or it may not be produced in Italy, but it's for Italy telco company. I like this white spiral cable. I keep it. So let's start with the headphone first. And let's keep the more interesting part later. And then again, a lot of dead weight. And typical suspects, connector, microphone and speaker again. Let's broke a small taps. The weight is massive. Oh, and this is interesting design. You can rotate speaker a little bit. And then you can take it out. I like that coil. It looks really beautiful and shiny. It seems like new. Back to the trash. Here you can see my lighting improvement for videos. So let's take the cover off. Oh, it smells really old. They even bothered to make this simple retaining clip to hold the flex cable better to the main board. Let's take a look what's inside the keyboard. I need to use a little bit force. The clips are flying away. I wondered what that white plastic was in the buttons. I was thinking that it's some kind of rubber material, but it's only white plastic for the numbers on the other side. Do we have all the buttons? No, we don't. Oh, they are on the ground. I don't need them anymore, so to the trash we go. Here I noticed that the manufacturer of this keypad is known company. Molex. Little cleanup, and we go to the main board of the telephone. Again, interesting custom switch. And also, I have no use for the switches, so just let's fly by the PCB to see the manufacture days. This could be 24 week of year 99, I guess. So let's take a look inside the switch. A little spring. I will need a more force. So this is a nice, clever design. And I don't need that switch anymore. I like destroying things. So let's open that piezo speaker, piezo buzzer. And I think the piezo is the only thing I can salvage from this board. Usually, you won't find piezo speakers in toys and custom electronics like that. This is quite big piezo. These piezo speakers can be handy for digital drummers or digital percussion players. You can use these piezo speakers as a trigger to play the samples of the percussion. So let's desolder the piezo. And this is a really terrible iron. takes some time, then takes some more time to heat up. We can relax a little bit. Almost there. And we can go. It seems like it's a leaded solder, so it went pretty quick. And that's all for today. Please rate this video or comment so I will know what you think about these teardowns. And you can also subscribe to my channel, because that always helps. Thank you and see you later!